Assalamu alaikum, dear students. In the last lecture, we have discussed the problems with computation in real DC machines. In this lecture, we will have a look at the solutions to the problems with computation. In DC machine, the computation is very important process through which AC production in DC machines is converted into DC at the output terminals. As you can see in this figure, this is the AC internal generated voltages in DC machine, and this is the output DC voltages at the output terminals. For this process, that is AC to DC conversion, commutator segments are placed at the router of the DC machines that converts AC into DC. As you can see in this figure, these are the commutator segments. This is the commutator segment A and this is the commutator segment B, which are used to convert AC internal generated voltages into DC. During this commutation, that is AC to DC conversion, there are some problems occur that we discussed in the last lecture of commutation problems. The first one is armature reaction and the second one is LDI over DT voltages. These two issues or problems severely affect the commutation process, that is AC to DC conversion. In this lecture, we will discuss the solutions of these problems or these issues that occurs with the commutation. So let's get started with the solutions to the problems with commutation. To solve the problems of commutation, that is armature reaction and LDI over DT voltages, there are these three main techniques are used that are listed here. The first one is brush shifting, the second one is interpoles, and the third one is compensating windings. So these are the main solutions widely accepted in the process of solving the problems, that is armature reaction and LDI over DT voltages. Let's discuss these three techniques with the detail. The first solution to the problem with commutation is brush shifting. First time the effect was done to make some improvement in the commutation process was introduced to reduce the sparking effects caused by armature reaction and LDI over DT voltages. As we know, magnetic neutral plane is shifted in the direction of rotation in case of generator and in opposite direction in case of motor. Let us assume that if we will shift the brush manually in the direction of magnetic neutral plane, then the problem of sparking can be completely or partially reduced. That is, we want to shift the brushes in the direction of magnetic neutral plane as well. By doing this, we can reduce the problem of sparking across the brushes completely or partially. The figure of DC machine is shown here. As you can see in this figure, this is the North Pole and this is the South Pole. There are 8 coils. This is the coil number 1, coil number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. As we know, in case of no load, that is when we not apply the load, the magnetic neutral plane, magnetic neutral plane is the plane where the internal generated voltage is zero. As we know, in case of no load, at that position, the internal generated voltage is zero. As we know, E is equal to V cross B dot L. V means velocity and B means magnetic field. In case of no load, at that point, the velocity of the conductors and the direction of the magnetic fields from north to south both are parallel. In case of parallel, V cross B is zero. That's why the internal generated voltage is zero. If at that point where the internal generated voltage is zero, that plane is called the magnetic neutral plane. The magnetic neutral plane lies here. Let the direction of rotation is counterclockwise, as you can see in this figure. For example, the machine is generator. As we have already discussed, cross means the direction of current is inward, dot means the direction of the current is outward, as you can see in this figure. In case of no load, the magnetic neutral plane will lie here. As when we connect the load across the rotor of the DC machine, then magnetic neutral plane is shifted in the direction of rotation. Here the direction of rotation is counterclockwise. It means when we connect the load, then the magnetic neutral plane will shift in the counterclockwise direction due to armature flux. Magnetic neutral plane will come like this. If we increase the load further, then the magnetic neutral plane will shift further, as you can see in this figure. Because when we connect the load, then the current will flow across the rotor conductors. Due to armature current, magnetic field will produce across the rotor. These magnetic fields will affect the original magnetic fields from north to south. Due to this, the direction of the magnetic field from north to south little will change. Due to this, magnetic neutral plane will shift in the direction of rotation in case of generator. If our magnetic neutral plane is here, then we will keep our brushes here to reduce the sparking effect. We want to shift the brushes in the direction of magnetic neutral plane to reduce the sparking effect across the brushes. Because we want to shift the brushes at that point as well where the internal generated voltage is zero. If the voltage at that point is zero, then the effect of sparking will be zero as well. When we connect the load, magnetic neutral plane is shifted in the direction of rotation. Like if the magnetic neutral plane is lie here and the brushes lies here, so we want to shift the brushes in the direction of magnetic neutral plane to avoid the sparking. There is no phenomena inside the machine to automatically shift the brushes with magnetic neutral plane. The brushes in the machine are fixed. Inside the machines, there is no automatically phenomena. There is no phenomena inside the machine to automatically shift the brushes from that position to that position. To do this, someone will have to shift manually. It looks a good option. It looks a good option, but it also creates some problems to shift the brushes magnetic neutral plane. The neutral plane changes its position with load variation. If we increase the load, the magnetic neutral plane will shift further. If we decrease the load, then the magnetic neutral plane will shift to opposite direction. It means the magnetic neutral plane is dependent on the load. Then we have to hire a man on the machine to adjust the location of the position of the brushes as the neutral plane changes according to the load variation. Because when we change the load, the current across the rotor conductor changes. Due to this, the position of magnetic neutral plane changes as well. So that's why we have to hire a man on the machine to adjust the location of the position of the brushes as the magnetic neutral plane changes according to the load variation. If we convert this machine from generator to motor, then the rotation of magnetic neutral plane will be opposite, that is, will be clockwise. Let us suppose that if we vary the positions of the brushes according to magnetic neutral plane, it might decrease the flowing at the brushes. Nevertheless, it increases the flux weakening effect of the armature reaction in the machine. If we shift the brushes with magnetic neutral plane manually, then due to this shifting, the effect of flux weakening will increase. This is the disadvantage of this technique. The flux weakening the flux weakening problem will increase as well due to shifting the brushes with magnetic neutral plane. As we have already told you, flux weakening process will reduce the voltage in the generator and cause high speed in the motor. As we know, the relationship between the internal generated voltage and flux is directly proportional. If the flux is decreases, then the internal generated voltage will decrease as well. And the relationship between the speed of the motor is inversely proportional to the flux. If the flux will decrease, then the speed will increase. Let me take the machine as a generator. Generator and motor, it does not matter, everything is the same. Now, let us first draw the vector diagram in case of no load to understand the flux weakening problem. In no load condition, as you can see in this figure, we are having a field flux here, that is from north to south. This is the main field flux, that is the field from north to south is the main field flux. And the flux due to armature is 90 degree apart. As you can see in this figure, the flux due to the main fields is from left to right, that is from north to south, is shown here. This is the magnetomotive force of the stator. The direction of the magnetomotive force here is from left to right, as you can see in this figure. This is the stator magnetic motive force, or the main field magnetomotive force, due to north and south pole. And the armature fields are shown here, when the current will flow inside, and here the direction of the current is outward, and here the direction of current is inward. Due to this current across the rotor conductors, magnetic field will produce. And this is the direction of the magnetic field, as we have already discussed in the previous lecture. As you can see in this figure, the armature magnetic fields, the direction of the armature magnetic fields is upward. As you can see in this vector diagram, the direction of the rotor magnetomotive force or armature magnetomotive force is upward. And the resultant is shown here. This is the net magnetomotive force. As you can see in this figure, this is the vector diagram in case of no load. This is the resultant magnetomotive force. Now, when we connect the load, we will see what happened. Because we have shifted the magnetomotive force in case of when we connect the load, then the current across the armature coil or rotor coil will increase. Due to this current, armature reaction will increase. Due to this armature reaction, magnetic neutral plane will shift in the direction of rotation. Due to this shifting, we will shift the brushes as well. What we have done is that this is the flux due to the main fields. That is, the flux due to the main fields is from north to south, as you can see in this figure. When we increase the load, then the current across the rotor coils will increase as well. As you can see in this figure, the direction of the main field flux is shown here from north to south, and this is the direction of magnetic field from north to south, that is from left to right, as you can see in this figure. When the magnetic neutral plane will shift with the load, then we will shift manually the brushes from old magnetoneutral plane to new magnetic neutral plane, as you can see in this figure. Now, the direction of the magnetic fields across the rotor conductors is, now the voltage will induce in these conductors as well. Here will be cross and here will be dot. Now, the direction of the magnetic fields due to the armature conductors is shown here. And at that point is shown here. Now, as you can see in this figure, the direction of magnetic fields due to the rotor conductors are shown here. And now we will draw at the vector diagram this direction of the magnetic fields. This is the direction of the magnetic fields due to the rotor or armature coils. So this is the rotor magnetomotive force now after connecting the load. At the start, in case of no load, this was the position of the original magnetomotive force. When we connect the load, the direction of the rotor magnetic motive force is shifted in the direction of rotation. Now, the new resultant or net magnetic motive force is shown here. This is the old magnetomotive force in case of no load. This is the new or net magnetomotive force in case of loaded generator. As you can see in this figure, the total net magnetomotive force is reduced as compared to no load. Why is it happening? That is, to reduce the flux. Because we shifted the brush position, we are having a component of our major flux, which is actually having a demagnetizing effect on the main fields. As we have already discussed, the main disadvantage of brush shifting techniques are, the first one is the flux weakening problems increase. And the second one is, as load varies, the position of the magnetic motive force will vary as well. The disadvantages of brush shifting technique is shown here. The first one is magnetic neutral plane is load dependent. It means when we change the load across the DC machines, the position of the magnetic neutral plane will change. And the second drawback of brush shifting technique is direction is dependent whether machine is a motor or generator. As we have already discussed, in case of generator, the magnetic neutral plane is shifted in the direction of rotation. In case of motor, the magnetic neutral plane is shifted in opposite direction. And the third disadvantage of brush shifting technique is aggravates the flux weakening. That is, the flux weakening problem is increased by using this technique. So that's why it is only used in very small motors, where other better solutions are not economical. So this solution nowadays we do not apply in DC machines. These solutions, after 1910, the brush shifting technique for reduction of sparking has been eliminated. Nowadays, this method is only used for DC motors of small rating, not for generators. For these motors, this technique is less expensive than others. The second solution to the problem with commutation is interpoles or commutating poles. As we discussed above, a permanent person or magnet needs to change the position of carbon brushes with the load. As when we vary the load, then a person is needed to shift the brushes with the magnetic neutral plane. There is another solution to this issue, that we eliminate the voltage in the conductor that doing commutation. In this way, flashing will be decreased. To do this, small pole that is known as interpoles or commutating poles is placed among the main poles of the machines. It means in this technique we introduce a small poles between the two main poles, that is at that position and at this position. In this technique we will not shift the position of the brushes with magnetic neutral plane. As we have already discussed, there are a lot of drawbacks of brush shifting technique. The second technique is interpoles or commutating poles. These small poles are connected with the wires that is using in the commutation process. These small poles have their own flux, that is, we introduce here small poles, that is north pole and south pole in the machine. These small poles have their own flux. As you can see in this figure, this is the north pole, this is the south pole, and the direction of the magnetic fields is from north to south. Similarly, we introduced a small pole between the two main poles, that is from north and south pole, we will introduce in the machine. These small poles are connected with the wires that is using in the commutation process. These small poles have their own flux. This flux will interact with the conductors. Our problem is, as you can see in this figure, we do not want to induce voltage at these conductors. If the EMF is induced at these conductors, we want to cancel out the EMF at these conductors to minimize the effect of brushes. In these solutions, the brushes will be at this position. We will not shift the brush. Now we will discuss the basic theory of interpoles. We will discuss in detail the basic theory of interpoles. As in no load condition, the magnetic neutral plane will be perpendicular to the main fields. These are the main fields. In case of no load, the magnetic neutral plane is perpendicular to the main fields. As you can see in this figure, the direction of the main fields is from north to south. And this is the magnetic neutral plane. And the angle between the magnetic fields and the plane is 90 degrees in case of no load. These perpendicular conductors have no EMF. These conductors are no EMF in this particular condition. As we know, at that point, the velocity of the conductors and the direction of the magnetic fields both are parallel. In case of parallel, the induced voltage is zero, as E is equal to V cross B dot L. And in case of parallel, the angle is 0 degree or 180 degree. Sine 0 or 180 is 0. That's why E is equal to 0. It means at that position, the internal generated voltage is 0. That's why this plane is called magnetic neutral plane. As when we load the machine called generator, that is when we connect the load across the rotating part of the machine, that is across the rotor, the magnetic neutral plane will shift. In case of no load, the position of the magnetic neutral plane was at that point. When we connect the load across the generator, the magnetic neutral plane is shifted in the direction of rotation. Now, this is the new position of magnetic neutral plane when we connect the load across the rotors. When we connect the load across the rotor, then the current will flow across these conductors. Due to this current, the magnetic neutral plane is shifted now in the direction of rotation. So what would happen? There, the conductor at this position, the induced EMF will be zero now. As you can see in this figure, this is the new magnetic neutral plane. We know magnetic neutral plane is the plane where the induced voltages is zero. It means now at these conductors, the induced voltages will be zero instead of this position. By connecting the load, due to load, the current will flow across the armature winding or across these conductors. Due to this, the original magnetic field will disturb. Due to this, magnetic neutral plane will shift. Now, at these conductors, the induced EMF will be zero instead of these conductors. With the brushes are connected here. If the voltage is not zero here, then there will be sparking across the brushes. This is the main problem. Now, these conductors will have EMF where brushes are connected. This is the basic theory of problems with commutation. We want the voltages, we want the induced EMF is zero where the brushes is connected. This is the basic theory of problems with commutation. In that case, there will be sparking across the brushes. So what can we do to avoid the sparking instead of shifting the brushes? Now, in this technique, we do not want to shift the brushes. We want to अब टू मिनिमाइज और रिड्यूस द स्पार्किंग अक्रॉस हेयर इंस्टेड ऑफ शिफ्टिंग द ब्रशेज. दैट इज हाउ कैन वी इलिमिनेट द EMF इंड्यूस्ड हेयर. द स्पार्किंग अक्रॉस द ब्रशेज इज ड्यू टू दीज कंडक्टर्स विच आर जनरेटिंग EMF नाउ. सो इन सिंपल वर्ड वी वॉन्ट टू रिड्यूस और वी वॉन्ट टू कैंसल आउट दीज EMF generated due to load connected with the rotating part of the machine. We can eliminate the induced voltages at these conductors. As you can see in this figure where the brushes are connected, we want to eliminate the induced voltages at these conductors by producing the counter EMF. If we produce the voltages opposite to these voltages, then these voltages can be cancelled out and overall effect will be zero and the sparking can be minimized. Effectively, the EMF at these conductors would be zero. In this way, sparking across the brushes will be zero. If this is the EMF in one conductor, let this is the EMF in one conductor. Here the direction of the current is inward and here the direction of the current is outward, as you can see in this figure. Here the direction of the current is inward and here the direction of the current is outward. We want to eliminate or we want to cancel out these voltages. If we want to cancel out these voltages, then counter EMF should be generated and the direction of the EMF will be at this point, the direction of the current should be outward. As you can see in this figure, this here is the direction the current is inward. If we generate opposite current, then this current will cancel out this current, the overall effect will be zero. And here the direction of the current will be inward. If we produce opposite EMF or counter EMF, this is the counter EMF. Similarly, this is the counter EMF. This is the main EMF which is generated due to the shifting of magnetic neutral plane when we connect the load across the rotor. We want to this EMF zero. We can make this EMF zero by generating the counter EMF. It means we want to generate here opposite EMF to cancel out these voltages. If we cancel out these voltages, then where the brushes is connected, then the effect of sparking will be reduced or completely removed. So that's why we need to generate the counter EMF or the opposite direction of the EMF which is generated in the machine. If here the direction is inward, then we generate here the EMF, the direction of the EMF will be outward. Then this fact will be cancelled out. And the remaining EMF will be, remaining conductors will be like this. If this fact will be cancelled out, it means the voltage across these conductors will be zero again. That is the basic solution provided by the interpoles. It means we can do this by introducing the interpoles between the two main poles. Basic theory is that if voltages were undergoing commutation, that is these voltages are undergoing commutation, can be made zero, there will be no sparking in the brushes. What do we do? Small poles over conductors, The problem is we want the EMF zero here. It means the counter EMF will be generated. For this purpose, we introduce a small poles over these conductors, because these conductors creating problems due to this, the sparking occurs across the brushes. So small poles are conductors that are going to undergo commutation. What we do is that we can make up small poles here at this position. We can made up a small poles here, as you can see in this figure. These are the small poles. This is the pole number 1 and this is the pole number 2. To remove the EMF across these conductors, we introduce a small poles here. And when the conductor is rotating, because of these small poles, counter EMF will be generated. When the conductors will rotate, when the conductor will come at this position, and when the voltage or EMF will induce at that point, the small poles will generate the counter EMF. That EMF will cancel out this EMF. The overall effect will be zero here, and there will be no sparking across the brushes. As you can see in this figure, there is a sparking occurs between the brushes and commutator segments. As you can see, this is the sparking. We want to remove this sparking, because due to this, there are a lot of drawbacks. Due to this, the commutator segments can damage and the maintenance cost of the machine will be high. So how to cancel this particular EMF? If this is the crosshair, we should have a dot here to cancel the EMF, and this is the dot here. It means the interpoles should generate the counter EMF to cancel the EMF across these conductors. If the direction of the, as we know, cross means the direction of the current is inward, it means we should have generate EMF where the direction of the current should be outward. Here the direction of the current is inward. Due to interpole, the direction of the current should be outward. Due to this, the effect of these effect will be cancelled out and there will be no sparking across the brushes. And similarly, here is the dot where the brush is connected. It means the interpole will generate the cross. It means the direction of the current due to interpole should be inward. And the direction of the current already across these conductor is outward. If the interpoles will generate the direction of the current is inward, then this effect or EMF cross these conductor will be cancelled out and the effect of sparking across the brushes will be minimum. We will keep our poles here at that position, because such that when the conductor passes through this particular pole or this particular point, outward EMF here and inward EMF here. So that's why this should be north pole and this pole should be south pole. As we know, the direction of the velocity here is at this particular point is from right to left. This is the direction of velocity at this point. If this is the direction of the magnetic field, then the generated EMF or the direction of the current at that point will be outward. So we want to the direction of the current here outward to cancel out the effect of or EMF generated in these conductors. Similarly, at that point, the direction of the current at these conductors is outward. We want to cancel out this outward effect. It means this pole should generate the EMF like that, where the direction of the current should be inward. Then the effect of EMF, which is connected where the brush is connected, will be cancelled out. In case of generator, the interpoles polarity, that is north or south, should be upcoming poles. If this is the north pole, this should be the north pole as well. Well, in case of generator, in case of motor, the polarity of interpoles always the previous pole. As we know, the polarity of previous pole is north, so that's why this pole should be north as well. This is not a complete solution. The interpoles only cancel the sparking across the brushes, but still flux weakening effect is there, because the flux weakening is happening in this area under the north and south poles. So that's why this is not a complete solution. The interpoles only cancel the sparking across the brushes, but still flux weakening effect is here, because flux weakening is happening under the north and south pole. So what to do? We want to a complete solution to cancel the sparking of the brushes and also to reduce the flux weakening problem. That is where the third solution come, that compensating winding. Now we will discuss the third method to improve the commutation. The third method is compensating windings. This technique will help us to reduce the flux weakening problem. As we know, flux weakening problem exists under the north and south poles. Remember, this particular technique will not help us to overcome the LDIODT voltages. For that, you will still use interpoles, as this technique only help us to minimize the effect of flux weakening. That is, flux weakening problem exists under the north and south poles. This method will not help us to minimize the sparking across the brushes. To minimize the sparking across the brushes, we will use the technique number two, that is interpoles. So you see in this diagram, this is the north pole and this is the south pole. Let the direction is counterclockwise or anticlockwise. You can clearly see in the pole face, I have made a slots as well under the north pole slot and under the south pole. I have made here the slots. These three slots are under the north pole and three slots are under the south pole. So basic theory here is that how to reduce the flux weakening problem. So our main objective is to introduce a technique. By using this technique, how can we reduce the flux weakening problem, as the flux weakening problem exists under the north and south poles. Basically, flux weakening problem originates because of these conductors. These conductors are under the north pole and these conductors are under the south pole. Due to these six conductors, three conductors are under the north pole and three conductors are under the south pole. Due to these conductors, flux weakening problem exists, which is called armature fields. As we know, in case of these conductors, here the direction of the current is inward, here the direction of the current is outward. When we connect the load, due to this load, current will flow across these conductors. Due to this current, magnetic field will produce, and the direction of the magnetic field, we already know the direction of the magnetic field will be like this. And here the direction of the magnetic field will be like this. Due to these conductors, here the direction of the current is inward, here the direction of the current is outward. By applying the right hand rule, thumb will place in the direction of the current and fingers will show the direction of the magnetic field. Similarly, here the thumb will place in the direction of the current, that is outward, and fingers will show the direction of the magnetic field. Here is the direction of the magnetic field. This is we have already found. In this side, a clockwise direction, as you can see in this figure, in this side the direction of the magnetic field is clockwise, and here the direction of the magnetic field due to these conductors is counterclockwise, and the direction of the magnetic field due to main fields, that is due to north and south poles, is from left to right, as you can see in this figure. So this is the armature flux and this is the main field flux. This armature flux was causing the flux weakening problem in the machine. It means due to this armature flux, the direction of the magnetic field or magnetic field disturbed. Due to this, the value of the magnetic field start to reduce. These armature flux causing the problems. We want this armature flux to cancel out. We want these flux should be zero. Our main objective is the flux across armature should be zero. If we cancel this effect by introducing the opposite field, then the flux weakening problem can be solved. At this particular point, here the flux will be weak because here the main fields, the direction of the main fields is from left to right, and the direction of the armature flux at this particular point is from right to left, and both will be cancelled out each other. Here the strength of the flux will be increased because here the direction of the main fields and the direction of the armature flux both are in the same direction. Here the flux will be strengthened. Similarly, here the flux will be strengthened, here the flux will be weakening. Now, what if we have another type of winding which are part of the machine as constructed here, which would cancel out this particular flux? That's why I have put three slots here, three slots under the north pole and three slots under the south pole. We want to cancel out the armature flux because due to armature flux, flux weakening problem exists in the machine. Our main objective is to cancel out the armature flux, as you can see in this figure. That's why I have put three slots here under the north pole and three slots under the south pole to cancel out the armature flux. These conductors in these slots, as you can see in this figure, I have created three slots under the north pole and three slots under the south pole. This is called the compensating winding. Here the direction of the mean or armature flux is counterclockwise. It means, as you can see in this figure, so our flux due to compensating winding, these three coils or these three conductors, so our flux due to compensating winding should be in the counterclockwise, because the armature flux is counterclockwise and so our flux due to compensating winding should be clockwise. If the direction of this direction of the flux due to compensating winding is clockwise and the armature flux is anti-clockwise, then both will be cancel out each other. Similarly here, as you can see in this figure, here the direction of the armature flux is clockwise. It means the compensating winding should generate or place in that way, these windings should generate the counterclockwise flux. The dotted line is the flux due to the compensating winding. Here the direction of the dotted line is counterclockwise and the direction of the armature flux is clockwise. Both will be cancel out each other. Now, how current will flow from these conductors? Now the question is, how the current will flow in these conductors which are placed, 3 are under the north pole and 3 are under the south pole. Take a connection from the brushes, because these conductors of the main rotor conductor are connected with the brushes. Same, the supply of these compensating winding of conductors will be from brushes. Take a connection from brush, as you can see in this figure. Similarly, in brush 2, I have connected the second end. The advantage of this is that as load varies, as we know, these are major conductors are connected with the brushes as well. And the supply, which supply is going to in these conductors, same supply is going to in the compensating winding. It means when the load will vary, then the current will vary. Then the current will vary at these conductors. Similarly, the current will vary at these conductors as well. It means the effect of will be cancelled out completely, as you can see in this. Therefore, whatever the armature flux increases, the counter armature flux, which is the compensating winding flux, will increase as well, and the net effect will be zero. It means the armature flux and the compensating flux will be cancelled out each other, and the flux weakening problem will be completely solved. The disadvantage is that it will never cancel the LDI over DT voltages, which is produced here, which is produced across the brushes. The compensating winding will never cancel out these voltages, which is across the brushes. It is only cancel the armature reaction. Compensating winding is only cancel the armature winding, and due to this, the only one problem can solve by using the compensating winding. The second problem is LDI over DT voltages will not solve the compensating winding, because LDI over DT voltages exist at across the brushes. By using this technique, we can solve the armature reaction, that is flux weakening problem, but can't be solved the LDI over DT voltages. To get complete cancellation, if we want to solve the both the problems, that is armature reaction, flux weakening, and LDI over DT voltages, that is sparking across the brushes, if we want to get complete cancellation, you have to provide interpoles as well. It means we will use interpoles as well. It means in case of complete solution, we will use interpoles and compensating winding in the machines to completely solve the problems with commutation, that is the conversion from AC to DC process. If we have such a configuration, that is interpoles and compensating windings, then both problems of computation can be solved. And finally, you will get the flux like this. As you can see in this figure, now this is the only flux due to the main fields, that is from north to south. And the flux across armature flux will cancel out with the compensating winding, and the sparking cross the brushes will be solved by using the interpoles, as you can see in this figure. Here are the interpoles and here is the compensating winding. That's it for this week's lectures.